Innovation Award is a competition which has been founded by KUKA 5 years ago, and it's about all the fancy stuff that you need to have in an advanced product and solution in the future. So the participants of the Innovation Award suggest to develop some cool technology or to demonstrate some cool technology with KUKA hardware.
The Innovation Award is something that shows how important it is to connect basically academia to industry in order that eventually we will have some good results society can use for good purposes.
It's a great opportunity to actually connect with interesting groups from academia and research institutes, and it is also a great opportunity for these guys to try their new and interesting concepts on our hardware.
One of the key ideas of the Innovation Award is that we equip the teams with KUKA hardware, but we also give them coaching, we also give them a training, and we advise them on how to do the application. So they really get a hands-on training on how to use our hardware and software and come up with the best solutions.
We are looking at visual perception, and we can learn from these guys, we can learn how they use our hardware, and we can also learn about new concepts.
The theme this year was a real world interaction, and that's very, very timely because, you know, robotics is changing. One of the important things is robots interacting with the real world, with humans.
Getting the robots closer to the humans, to reality, to the daily work, to get ideas about this 24/7 approach of robots.
So how can robots interact with the real world, which is dynamically changing?
This time we were looking for the team. I mean, the team is very important. How well is it established in the research community? So that's an important aspect, and how well we think they would be able to perform. The second aspect is the originality of the approach. What type of technologies are they integrating into the application? And I would say last but not least, it's the application domain, whether it's interesting in general for robot-based automation, and how it might be an economic pathway into the future. Is it sustainable what they are offering, and how can we make money in the future from these applications?
We had a very, very tough competition this year. We had 5 really, really good teams.
This year the award has been won by the IIT, very famous institute from Italy, and I think they have won the award because they could show from day one that their application was working, and it is a very cool application which can save billions of euros in healthcare.
Like, they combined many, many different things. They had vision, they had the dynamic model of a human, they had the KUKA EVA and an adaptive impedance control.
So they decided to develop an application where they monitor the postures of the humans and then try to have the robot adapt in a way that the posture of the human is the most ergonomic you can imagine.
So our challenge was, can we make the humans and robots physically engage and just assist each other, especially robot assisting the human? And this is the topic that ergonomics can be really important. So while assisting, can it ensure human ergonomics while performing the task?
I think it's very important in a competition like this to search for the real different stuff, something that can really be meaningful.
If you want to collaborate, I think you have to take care of the ergonomics of the application. And that's done in a fantastic way in this proposal to keep the humans in a healthy phase working with a robot.
I think we are really happy because all our efforts that we've been put over the last year has been paid off, and we are really glad to be able to show our expertise.
Yeah, we're really proud of the result that we reached, and we are really happy that thinking that maybe one day we can help people to improve in their life.
What is nicer than to look at cool stuff and cool innovations and to see students and teams working, you know, like crazy to make a difference? Orange Intelligenz.